KBYP with an update to the grounding video. Extremely important update. See the my first ham station video on this channel and go to the comments. KG4DDM, and the camera's being an annoyance, but I think you can read it. I still have a TS-440 that had an issue with a lightning strike that blew out the front end. Lightning hit a tree on the opposite side of the house, ran through the root system of the tree. Very likely, the roots are just full of water. And up the ground cable, the only thing that was hooked up to the radio. That's what you call radio death. This is why we never, ever ground amateur radio equipment. It is effectively illegal to do so. It's a significant violation of electrical code. And this is proof of what happens and why we don't do it. So on to the grounding video. This is KBYP making another pass at the question of why hams are so hung up on grounding their equipment. You got to put a metal plate down and ground all your equipment. No such thing exists in electrical code. I couldn't figure out where this is coming from. Somebody finally told me, and I finally get it. This all revolves around the definition of equipment. History, back in the 1920s and such, back in the days of crystal radios that are not amplified, with very low frequency and low frequency broadcast, AM broadcast, receivers might be crystal detectors that have no amplification. Those VLF and LF stations propagate energy through and along the ground in ground wave, and it was common to have long wire antennas that did not work worth a crap unless they were grounded. I've been there and done that. I made a crystal set back in the early 70s. It didn't work worth a hoot until I grounded it. In one of my previous antenna videos, I showed how a long wire has to be grounded and it forms a essentially capacitive pickup with this signal propagating along the ground, and that does not apply to HF because our HF signals don't go along the ground, they go up. Therefore, there's no reason and no future to ground an HF antenna. It's got nothing to do with picking up or transmitting signals. It has become practice in violation of code to ground amateur radio equipment. I didn't catch the problem here until somebody basically told me, well, my ham radio is equipment. I said, oh, no, wait a minute. Your ham radio is not electrical equipment. And I caught the problem. And the problem is in falsely defining a piece of amateur radio equipment such as that, which is engineered by a company with the grounding and safety necessary inside the unit, that is supplied by a cord and plug. And the electrical code specifically mentions cord and plug and double isolation like the electric drills and electric mixers in the kitchen. And that's the cord and plug for the Drake TR3 power supply. No ground. See it? Developed by engineers. And the mistake hams are making is in pretending that our radio equipment is equipment in the context of National Electric Code. Under NEC 2011 definitions, Article 100, equipment, a general term including fittings, pipe, devices, I don't know, surge protector, appliances, an electric dryer, luminaries, lights. There's my luminary, grounded. Apparatus, machinery. Drop in a lathe with a 240 motor, open up a box, connect a piece of armored cable from the lathe box to a breaker or switch box on the wall that is wiring in a piece of machinery, and the like, used as a part of or in connection with an electrical installation. It doesn't say in connection with electrical power service. It says an installation. Plugging that into that is not an installation. Consumers don't see this. Industrial electricians do. Segueing to the basement, there's an electric clothes dryer. I have done appliance repair. A common failure with that kind of dryer operated by electricity is that the heating element that runs on 240 gets old and the coiled nichrome wire stretches and the element falls and touches and shorts to the pan. That's the diagnosis. The pan is a stamp metal, probably galvanized steel, probably pan that holds the heating element in ceramic insulators, and that element gets old and stretches and physically touches the pan and energizes the chassis. This laundry area under electrical code is a wet area. On the back of this unit, there's clearly called out a ground connection which is required. If it's not there, somebody's going to die because a sagged heating element is very likely in an old dryer. Common failure. If that happens and the cabinet of that machine is not grounded and that heating element sags and somebody comes down here and touches that cabinet, they're dead. They're dead, Jim. This is electrical equipment. It's really intended to open up a panel on the back and take a piece of Romex or armored and connect it to the terminals and then run it up to a box. I mean, here's a water heater wired in from the enclosure here to the little gray box, which is the enclosure where it's hardwired. See the conduit, waterproof. That's electrical equipment wired into an electrical service installation, not a cord and plug. Here's cord and plug appliance in the kitchen. KitchenAid, popcorn popper, chopper and a hopper. You see a ground prong on that? You do not. Not required. Why? Because that is an appliance that is double insulated. You can't touch this and get shocked unless you take it apart, and that's deliberate. This, you cannot get shocked on that externally, although it is grounded. And right there it is. That's the mixer is on a grounded cord. The engineers that made these things that know all about them determine what grounding is or isn't necessary. And that's a function inside the unit, like it is inside an amateur radio transceiver. Do hams go around their kitchen grounding these appliances? No. So why do they ground their amateur radio transceivers? Because they're believing old myths and fairy tales. And that comes from the antenna systems of ancient days. Here is Article 11054, bonding equipment. Bonding and equipment grounding conductors, grounded and bonded. All non-current carrying metal parts of electrical equipment shall be solidly grounded and bonded to all metal pipes and rails. But that's for tunnel installations over 600 volts. High voltage and closed space hazard. Not amateur equipment. This is Article 800. Communication circuits wherein amateur radio is found. Service equipment. Breaker box, fuse box, switching panel, some system box, whatever, that is wired into electrical service. Not an amateur radio transceiver with a molded cord and plug and double insulated. There is nothing, I repeat, nothing in Article 800 that either mentions or specifies grounding amateur radio antennas, amateur radio coax, or amateur radio equipment. The only requirements in here are grounding towers, not antennas, and grounding for static dissipation, not grounding amateur radio equipment, which is forbidden under Article 250.24A5. It is a dangerous shock hazard to ground that for lightning, because lightning happens outside and it hits the yard. It energizes the ground wire and energizes the cabinets on these radios. Dangerous. Service equipment definition in Article 100. Derived from the idea of service, the conductors and equipment for delivering electric energy from the serving utility to the wiring system of the premises served. And that implies wiring something in, not plugging it in a convenience outlet. A radio transceiver is not service equipment. Service equipment, the necessary equipment usually consisting of a circuit breaker or switches and fuses, a fuse breaker or switching box, and their accessories connected to the load end of the service conductors to a building or other structure or an otherwise designated area and intended to constitute the main control and cutoff of the supply. Service equipment is not a load device, which is a radio transceiver. Therefore, it is absolutely, in every case, wrong to ground that. And again, it is two violations of 250.24A5, and there it is. A grounded conductor shall not be connected to normally not current carrying metal parts of the equipment, to equipment grounding conductors, or be reconnected to the ground on the load side of the service disconnecting means except as otherwise permitted in the article, which says the same thing. You are forbidden to ground your ham radio equipment. KBYP, dit dit.